place. Now, these are the fixtures of matches that will be going down this weekend, talking about the Nigerian Professional Football League. And the game between Kano Pillars and Akwa Starlets has been postponed. There's also, but a date has not been announced for that match. And also, the game between Abia Warriors and Akwa United has been moved to Thursday. That will be next week. But we have one of the Nigerian Professional Football League experts who spoke on the fixtures of matches, gave us a bit of analysis of how things will go down this weekend. He is Ikoji Ojekere, and he has given his voice on the Nigerian Professional Football League. Let's listen to him, and when we come back, we'll continue with the show.
Only 8 matches will be played on match day 2 of the NPFL, as 2 matches have been rescheduled. Matches involving Akwa and Abia Warriors, then the new team, Dakada versus Kano Pillars. But then let's look at the 8 matches that will be played. Katsina will play Eyimba, Adamawa United will play Rangers, Sunshine Stars will play Warri Wolves, Lobby Stars will play Delta Force, Rivers United host Heartland, MFA will be at home to FC Fanyoba, Jigawa Golden Stars host Plateau United, that's a Northern Derby, while Nasarawa United will play Wiki Tories. Let's take it one by one again. For Eyimba, is the first game. Remember, they were away in South Africa on Monday 1, where they claimed another victory over TS Galaxy and qualified for the group stage of the CAF Confederations Cup. So it's the first game of the season for Eyimba, away on the road at Katsina United. Katsina lost their first game, so this is a big one for them, crucial one. For newly promoted Adamawa United, they lost the first game. They're hosting Rangers. Just like Eyimba, Rangers played in the continent. They won, of course, they're true to the group stage of the CAF Confederations Cup, just like Eyimba. And so, it's the first game in the league. They're playing newly promoted Adamawa United. It's a long trip, I must confess, for Rangers. I don't envy them. For Warri Wolves, they make a short trip to Sunshine. It's the first game of the season for Sunshine. They didn't play too because Eyimba and Rangers, I mentioned earlier, were busy in the continent. So, Warri Wolves play Sunshine. Warri Wolves have a new coach in Evans Ogeyin, who left Lobby Stars, was on the backroom staff, but left Lobby Stars for Sunshine, for Warri Wolves. So it's a road trip for them. They played for a draw at home, a big one, I must say. When you go to Akure, it's not an easy trip, but in football, never say never. Lobby Stars lost. Was a big defeat for them. Plateau 1-3-1. They're hosting Delta Force, on paper, looks like an easy one for them. You expect Sikira Alimi to score again. He scored on the first day at Plateau United, so the fans will be looking forward to Sikiru to score again. Was busy with the national team, in the Chan qualifiers, in the WAFO Cup in Senegal, and Sikiru, of course, is a big name, a contender for the UNISA boat. But I think the biggest match of the weekend will be Rivers versus Heartland. They're close. This could be somehow called a derby. But the fact is this, Heartland lost their first game at home under new coach Fidelis Ilechukwu, who had, you can't talk about MFN without mentioning Fidelis Ilechukwu. He has several nicknames while there, the special one, the working one. But Heartland, he has to be working. He's yet to work because of the loss. And so a trip to Rivers United. Rivers claimed a point at Kano Pillars, difficult ground. But then when you can claim a point at Pillars, then coming back home, the fans expect them to roll over Heartland. And for Heartland, I must say, it's a difficult one. Having lost the first game at home, 3 points. If they lose again, 6 points, then no one will be smiling out there in a way. But that's the truth about it. Heartland playing Rivers United. Both teams have been fortified. Eguma on the side has brought in new players, just like Ilechukwu, who brought in some of his former players at MFM. He's got Akoneto with him. Akoneto was a free scorer at MFM. Let's see what will happen this weekend, Sunday, at the Yakubu Gowon Stadium in Port Harcourt. It's a pick of the pack for me. Then MFM again. Having won their first game away, now they are back home. Will they win? They are playing against FC Fanyoba. Over time, FC Fanyoba have become a team known for just having rookies. They used to have big names. Now it's a different, it's a new turn for them. They've got rookies, and their coaches have had issues with certificates. Initially, there was this warning from the LMC that they wouldn't be on the bench, but I think they've got the whole of the first round to sort that out. So we expect their coaches to be on the bench again, but this time around, against an MFM under Bulls who claimed maximum points away at home, the Agege Stadium. Fenerbah has never picked a point in Lagos, so let's see how this pans out. Then it's going to be a Northern Derby. Jigawa Golden Stars, newly promoted, to playing Plateau United. Plateau has been under pressure. Mikaba brought in all the big names last season. Didn't work out. Almost got relegated. A new season now. They started well, beating Lobby Stars 3-1. Let's see what happens against Jigawa. Jigawa lost their first game. So if they lose, if they draw, pressure begins to count. And the last game for match day two will be Nasarawa United versus Wicked Tories. Nasarawa didn't play too because Inba and Rangers were busy, so they're playing Wicked Tories. Both teams, of course, have also made some changes in their setup. Let's see how it pans out at the end of the day. But then I must say eight big games to be played, not to be missed, because the action continues. And of course, the race for the top scorer award. It might be early days, but then considering what UNICEF has put down, the guys will have their eyes on that. But the guy who is on two goals now, it's called a brace, as a Jimo Oni on the first day. His team isn't playing this weekend, but whenever that game comes up, let's see what Jimo Oni can bring out.
Well, great analysis from OJ Kerry, Ikoje right there, the CEO of Matchroom Sports and Media, and of course the publisher of Niger League Magazine. He knows everything going on in the Niger Professional Football League. Looking at the fixtures once again, he has given you analysis of those games. And I'm looking forward to the game between MFM and Ifeanyi Ubah. I remember MFM traveled away. That was last week against Heartland. They got a 1-0 victory, and that game was one to look out for, because MFM were playing against their former coach, talking about Fidelis Ilechukwu in that one, at Enyimba travel away from home to Katsina United. Interesting fixtures right there in the Niger Professional Football League.